live from Aspen, Colorado, global superstar Mariah Carey.
Wow.
Wow, check her out. Hey,
Mariah Carey.
Hi, guys.
MC Mariah, hey. You're on fire. Mariah,
how you guys
you
feel?
Had a huge, we feel good, we're lubricated.
We're so happy you're here.
Yeah, you had a huge year. I mean, all of those accomplishments. Do you have a personal highlight from the year?
Well, first of all, it's great to be here with you guys. The year, as we all know, has been challenging, to say the least. But I was really happy to be able to connect with, as I call them, the Lamely. They call themselves. And I mean, obviously, the book
the
being
Lamely.
Having the success and the critical acclaim that it's had. It's been my whole life's journey to actually write the book, be able to share my weird life story with everybody. And I think it's brought, just in terms of like me as an artist, closer to a lot of people who maybe didn't get me or didn't understand, you know, my dysfunctional upbringing and how that transcended things for me as a kid, a broke little biracial girl who grew up with nothing, and then being able to have the type of things you're talking about with this year. But obviously, the highlight is now, because we're leaving 2020 and hopefully having a better experience for us all, you know? And Anderson, I feel like I saw you every day, because all I did was watch CNN this entire time until Christmas. So it's
wow, I'm thrilled by that. I read your book, and I got to say, I mean, it's so, I'm friends with Michelangelo Davis, and I was so well written, and your story is so incredible, and it was just, it was such a good, powerful book. It wasn't, I didn't know what to expect, and I was just blown away by it. And reviewers were as well, and it's a number one bestseller. So congratulations on that. It's such a huge accomplishment. How do you celebrate New Year's Eve? Is it a moment?
I mean, typically it's a moment. I just want to speak to the fact, yay, Michaela Angela Davis, and I'm glad you brought that up. I know you guys used to work together for a minute.
Yeah.
She's amazing, and we had the best creative experience working on this book. I'm kind of like, okay, always for New Year's Eve, yes, it's a moment. We've had good moments, we've had bad moments, we've had moments, but they are what they are. This year, I think it's all about, we're here, it's just me and my family, very, very close family unit. We've been together this whole time during COVID, just figuring it out how to like exist and be festive during these times. So here we are. I hope you guys like it, what we created for you. You know, just
so
making it fun, and we can't be with you. We didn't leave New York for like 5 months, me and the kids. So yeah. I kind of feel a little bit detached from my roots. But I always love being here in Aspen, especially for Christmas. Because, by the way, I have not let Christmas die yet. Everybody wants to kill me because the Christmas music is still on 24/7.
Nor should it.
As it snows,
it.
I'm listening to Nat King Cole as it snows, and just like taking it. I feel like I got a bonus this year. You know, extended Christmas.
I gotta ask you about All I Want for Christmas Is You, because it keeps breaking so many records and so many records in the Spotify thing, the most streamed song ever in a day on Spotify. When you recorded All I Want for Christmas Is You, did you have a sense that it was gonna live for so long? Because it's one of those songs that you listen to and it still sounds like a brand new song. It's as fresh every time as you listen to it as the first time.
Thank you. Well, first of all, I hate to always say this, but as a writer, I wrote that song. And I think about it, I remember, yeah, but you know, you said recorded, so I just had to clarify that for the folks at home.
Oh.
No.
As you should.
Andy, you know. No, but I'm really proud of it in terms of that. But no, but really, it's because when I first wrote it, I was like, I just want to write about whatever makes me feel what I wanted to hear as a little kid, when I wanted my Christmases to be fun and festive, and they weren't necessarily, you know what I mean? So that's why as I've grown, I feel like I've grown up with it too. You know, I was kind of little when I first wrote it, littler in many ways. But yeah, I've grown to love it more and more, I think because I've experienced life with it as a listener, but also as someone that it's really I put everything into it. So I never knew it was gonna be this big, but I'm thankful. I know that much.
Yeah. You released the rarities from your vault. Tell us about it.
Yeah, it's we got J-Lo behind us, actually. I want to hear about Ariana Grande. She said in her new Netflix documentary, she got so emotional talking about what an influence you were for her and how she learned to sing by mimicking you. You know, now you came out with a song with her. That it was so great seeing the two of you together on your Christmas special. Talk to me about that.
So that was amazing. The Christmas special was an incredible moment, working with Apple and working with all the folks who were there. I loved working with Ariana and J-Hud. I wrote this song called Oh Santa, and I thought it would be cute for us to do like a girl group thing with it. So I rearranged it and figured out what we were going to do and how it was going to go, and then we filmed it. By the way, yay Apple, Apple TV Plus, because just getting through, like, we had the concept to do the special in February. I had it a year before, but, and then being able to do it during COVID, film it. We all had to be tested every day. Everybody was on set, like, who could be wearing shields and masks and everything. As you guys know, and for the people at home, the only reason I don't have a mask on right now is because, like, my shield is right over there and I asked for it, but they didn't give it to me. But everybody else has their masks, their shields, all of that. So I would just say thank you to everybody who participated in the special, because we've made it through the rain, and like so glad for the success of that, and looking forward to more to come, and just hopeful for a way better 2021 for the world, you know what I mean?
Yeah, what is your wish for everybody out there? I mean, a lot of folks have had a really tough year. It's going to be a tough year for a long time this year. There's obviously a vaccine coming, hope on the horizon. What's your hope for the new year?
Well, I think it's everybody's, I mean, I would imagine it's everybody's hope. Healing for our country, for the world. Unity, we've seen so much despair this past year, which has always been sort of there, underneath the surface. And I was grateful to be able to release my memoir, which dealt with so many issues of race and identity and, you know, just classism and just things that I've gone through as a human being, and then, of course, as a celebrity, whatever that means. And I think, you know, all of us have kind of come together a little bit more this year. And my hope or wish is that we continue to do so. Obviously, we all are ready for a new moment in terms of being hopeful about the vaccine and being hopeful for all of those, and really thinking about and wishing just the best of everything for those who've been affected by COVID, those who went through so much pain and who are still going through so much pain. We're celebrating, we're festive, but I think we're hopeful for better times.
You mentioned
the ball
the memoir.
Dropping? Seeing that?
No. The ball's not dropping yet. I have to ask you, you were so revealing in the memoir, and people thought that they knew so much about you. Was there one thing that you think people took away from the memoir that they didn't know about you or were surprised about you?
I don't know that there's one thing. I think there are many things, Andy.
It was a lot. You know,
There's a lot. Again, I put so much into it, and then the world turned upside down, and we were dealing with these very timely issues that people were like, oh, why are you suddenly talking about this now? But as you know, this has been a labor of love. We worked on the book for a good 2.5-3 years prior to it coming out, and then it was just all of a sudden this kind of relief, but also I didn't want people to be like, oh, now she wants to jump on this bandwagon or talk about that or whatever. No, it's just hard to encapsulate a lifetime in a 10-minute interview, or when we're on Watch What Happens Live cheersing, we're not sitting here talking about, you know, serious issues, because nobody wants to be, you don't want to be Debbie Downer. It's bad enough I'm not even having a splash with you guys right now.
Well, you need to have a splash with us right now. What's going to happen
Can
for the rest
splash?
Of the night
Somebody.
For you? Yes, get the girl a splash. Get the
Andy,
icon
I'm just not
a splash.
Used to talking to you without splashes. They're all looking
I know,
around trying to figure
I need,
it out.
I need you to have a splash. Tell me what will happen for the rest of the night for you, Mariah. How will you ring in the new year in Aspen?
Well, there is a 10 p.m. curfew that I just got an alert on my phone about.
Oh, my gosh.
But we're here. Yeah. Yeah, no, it's pretty surreal here, and I've never seen it so empty in the streets and stuff. But, yeah, I only care about, oops, Flash coming in. Yay!
Oh.
Yay!
Cheers in advance.
Oh, wait, we'll get a Splash too here.
Yeah, don't act like you didn't have one sitting around.
Yes, we've had plenty. We've had plenty.
And I've been waiting for you guys. I had like 3 coffees. I was like, let me be alert. And I'm sorry that because it's always so hard to not cut everybody off and to, you know, to have a communicative moment. I've fallen victim to that many times. But anyway, for tonight, we're going to just ring in the new year here, small group, just family and super close people that are close to us. And again, it's been a year of kind of isolation.